them too. We're filming from that camera back there. For those who are at home, you might like to know that the program is online, and if you click in the description below, there's a link to it. You might have to click the show more little button, or if you're watching it on a phone or a small device, there's a little arrow pointing down just underneath your screen. Click that and you'll find the link to the program. So please look for that. Lots of interesting things in there to read. So we've been busy this afternoon rehearsing. There have been some slightly strained moments, I have to say, but we've got through that and we're going to enjoy this evening's concert. I should perhaps say that the effect that 2 years of COVID has had on choral singing has been fairly devastating, because that was one of the things we really couldn't do, choral singing. So we've really had to build up the choir this year, and I'm tremendously proud of the pupils behind me. They've worked very hard. We've set quite a challenging repertoire for this evening, with the Faure Requiem, the Cantique de Jean Racine, the Miserere May by Allegri, and I'll tell you a little bit more about that in a moment. But they've really done extremely well to learn it. And we've relied a lot on the help from adults and help. So I'm very indebted and grateful to the adults that are behind me who give up their Wednesday evenings to come along and sing here in Clayesmore Chapel. But we are looking for more adults. So if any of you would like to join and sing with us on a Wednesday evening at 6:30, you're very welcome to do so. It's a bit of a choral society. And I'm keen to build all that up to the levels that we used to have. We used to have 80 pupils in the choir here, so we're certainly building up to that, and that's our aim. So as well as those seminal pieces, which it's great for the pupils to have the experience of performing them with an orchestra, we also have some instrumental music this evening. So the chamber strings are going to give the singers a bit of a break, and they're going to play Eine, kleine, Nachtmusik by Mozart. And we're also going to have a wonderful solo item sung by Tim Hamlin, It Is Enough, from Mendelssohn's Elijah. And we rehearsed that earlier today. It was absolutely electric. So I'm looking forward to that very much. I think that's enough talking from me, and we're going to do some singing now. We're going to start with one of my personal favourites, in fact, the Cantique de Jean Racine, which is by Faure. So we're opening with Faure, and we're going to finish with Faure also this evening.
Thank you.
Enough from Elijah by Mendelssohn. Mendelssohn was a romantic composer, Victorian period. In fact, he was a good friend of Queen Victoria and Prince Albert. And he revived a lot of Baroque music. So he performed pieces by Bach and Handel that hadn't really been performed since the Baroque period. And it was hugely popular in Victorian England. They loved to sing oratorios, pieces which had a chorus and soloists, and this was a great form of entertainment. So Mendelssohn wrote his own most of you will recognise this. If you don't recognise it from the title, it's the very high one. And when I say high, I mean stratospheric, for one soprano. And that soprano is Lucy Lille, who is sitting in the front here. And Lucy has to go right up to top Cs numerous times in this core item. And there's quite a lot of mystery about this piece. So it's from the Renaissance period, from the 1600s. It was written by Gregorio Allegri, and it was written really for the Sistine Chapel Choir in the Vatican in Rome, and only for them. So it was their piece to perform in Holy Week, leading up to Easter every year, but only they could perform it. So it wasn't publicly available, and it was a closely guarded secret, all the harmonies and how it went, until Mozart came along. So Mozart, at the age of 14, he went to listen to the Sistine Chapel performing this piece, and he memorized it. Now, it's actually very repetitive. It's a bit like verse, chorus. So he heard it many times. But at the age of 14, he was able to memorize it and then go back to where he was staying in Rome, write it down, and then he went back the next day and heard it again just to check, make sure he got it right. And from then on, it was in the public domain. And it's now one of the most iconic choral pieces from the Renaissance period. We've never performed it here at Clayesmore, at least not in my time. I've always felt it's a bit too challenging, and we've never really had a soprano who can hit top C. So we're very pleased that Lucy's here, and we're hoping to keep this one in the repertoire. So it's the Miserere by Allegri.
Thank you.
after the solos, which are fabulous. But we will show our appreciation at the end of the Requiem. So by all means, shuffle around a little bit between the movements, and I know the choir will. Maybe they'll be sitting down and standing up in places. But we won't clap until the very end. So, Faure is Requiem, starting with the introit, Sanctus, the Piaeus, which is a wonderful soprano solo, which will be sung by Nancy Bolton from the pulpit up there. Then the Agnus Dei, and then the Ligurame, which also features a soloist, Sebastian Hamlin, who also sing from the pulpit when it comes to it, and then finishing with the In Paradiso. Grimwood has joined us this year in September as the Assistant Director of Music, and he's a fabulous organist. And I'm so pleased that we have such safe hands there with Mr. Grimwood, and that I can concentrate on everything that's going on here. So a big round of applause for Mr. Grimwood.
Remains for me to wish you a very good evening, and thank you for coming along.